This morning, the message of the Lord is saying, go and sin no more. And then, I'm here this morning to explain the terms of go and sin no more, because it has a term. It's not like the way people look at it, like go and sin no more, you know. The first clause of this term is to stay broken, to stay like humble in your heart, knowing that the Lord has given you a chance. You know, it's not like you deserve the chance, but this chance is not given to you. That's the first thing with this command. It is a command, but it comes with terms. It comes with terms, and that will be the center of our discussion this wonderful morning. Discovered that in the process of celebrating the festival or the feast of Tabernacle, that they have to stay in boots to remind themselves of what the Lord has done. You know, they have to construct little boots, you know, with palm trees, like the palm plants and all that, because to stay in those places to remind themselves that the Lord has brought them out of slavery. You know, Ezra was a scholar of the Lord, of Yahweh, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You know, my father here would have made mankind celebrate this feast in different purposes, with different names, just to get them to remember where they are coming from, you know, so as to stay humble and do and try as much as possible not to trip to them, you know, with the pride of saying, I am this, I am that, when you are nothing. I don't care who you think you are, but whatever you are, the Lord made you. And you must stay humble if you want to advance from that particular position, because my father is not in the business of taking something away from someone. He has given something. No, the Lord did not give you that position so that people will worship you instead of the Lord himself. The Lord did not bless you so that people will not start worshiping you instead of me. The less you say him, the more who I am. Instead of, like, you know, getting people to understand that these things were done by the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and then you want to take credit for them. Now, the King of Kings is giving a chance this morning for us to go and sin no more. Before you tell the Lord, do you know who I am? Remember to ask yourself, do you know where the Lord Yahweh is? Do you know He's the one doing those things in your life? Do you know the King of Kings and Lord of Lords? You know? You're bringing back now just because of Him. The Feast of Tabernacle is the Feast of the Altar. It is the Feast of Sacrifice. It is the Feast of the ultimate sacrifice. You know? Because what is the need of your altar if it doesn't connect to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Yahweh Himself? What is the need of your altar if it doesn't connect to the Most High King, Yahweh? That's why religious institutions have embarked on fasting and staying in boots to humble oneself. But if after embarking on those activities and you can't really stay humble, then I don't know what should be done to your hypocrisy. Religion is a means, you know, but you must accept it in the greatest order that can connect easily to the most. Most High, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Yahweh. I'm talking about your heart. That's the order, the purpose. You must become humble in your heart. That's when your heart becomes the perfect heart of praise. So you must rely on the Lord. Holy. Remember that the perfect heart of praise by your spiritual Matthew French Google has a number of course is on Amazon.com now. You can obtain it. Learn how to obtain anything from the Lord through praise. You are still listening to Church on Radio. I am Martin Lefranche Gregory as I'm the person who now listens to the 5 of 10 on the Sabbath. We'll be right back after this praise. You know? We want to praise and worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Here is your holy. And after that comes Mighty God by Samuel Wilson.